follow. In the book of Luke, chapter 6, Jesus heals a man on the Sabbath. And the Pharisees, who were the religious people of that day, freaked out. Freaked out because he healed somebody on the Sabbath day. And they were so caught up in the legalism of their law keeping that they missed this miracle that Jesus just healed somebody. I mean, how blind can you be? And see, the question I ask you is, if you're following Jesus, are you following legalism of rule keeping? Are you following the master of life? Now, yeah, there's some rules we ought to keep, but they don't involve drinking, smoking, dancing, chewing, and go with women who do. They don't involve that. That's legalism. And there's a whole list of legalism that we can get caught up with. And that's what the Pharisees, they got caught up in so much legalism, they missed the miracle. So I'm asking you who you're following. Are you following religion that has its roots in ritual? Are you following a relationship with God that has its roots in grace? Who are you going to follow? Are you going to serve religion and its rule-keeping, or Jesus and its grace-giving? I'm going to choose Jesus. Now, understanding in grace, I have some expectations of behaviors that I need to change, that I'm not conformed to the image of this world, but I'm transformed by the renewing of my mind, and that in my purity and holiness and seeking to live like him, there's some things that I'm not going to do because I love him, not because I'm legalistic, because I love him and I want my life to look like him. But I'm not going to be controlled by legalism. And the things that don't matter, don't matter. And the one who does matter, King Jesus, matters. So Jesus asked the Pharisees this, who's it right to serve, God or religion? Law or the Messiah? I'm choosing Jesus. What about you?